This week, let's talk about sex. Or more specifically, how you can channel your sexual energy to create sexual transmutation, as Napoleon Hill referenced in the book, Think and Grow Rich. Randy Gage here. I want to welcome you to another episode of Prosperity TV. As you can see, I'm back home again in San Diego, and we got a fascinating topic this week. This is something I get so many questions on this when I reference it in a blog or on the Periscope broadcast or anytime at the live events. It's this issue of sexual transmutation. And I think why it's so intriguing to people is because sex is such a taboo subject for so many people around the world. So let's start with that as we explore this issue. I think we need to look at the foundational issues about sex and sexuality that may cause you to self-sabotage your success through developing worthiness issues or judging others, making decisions based on bad information. So let's begin with that. Here's the things I want you to think about. Here's your critical thinking, your homework for this week. What were your core foundational beliefs that you were taught about sex before you were 10 years old? Because if you're a regular viewer of the show, you know we've talked about all of the important prosperity issues: sex, money, God, religion, relationships, marriage. Your core foundational beliefs about those things, and they're all really important to make to manifest in prosperity in your life. All of those, for most people, are set before they're 10 years old. They're literally created when you're 6, 7, 8, 9 years old, based on your parents, who raised you, your caregivers, your coaches, your teachers, the environment that you are surrounded by. So I want you to think about, what were your core foundational beliefs about nudity? What was taught in your house? Was that natural and accepted, or was that a dirty thing? What were you taught as you get into puberty and we were learning about sex? Was that a dirty thing? Did your family talk disparaging about it? Were you influenced by religious programming that it would keep you out of heaven or keep you out of the afterlife, or that if you practiced that or were involved with that, you were a sinner or you were a flawed human being? Explore those. What were your core foundational beliefs about that? Because if you think sex is dirty or nudity is bad, that's a problem, because that's not a belief that serves you. Sex is this wonderful, glorious, beautiful part of who we are as human beings, and it's part of the dynamic. And there's certainly nothing wrong with nudity in the proper context, right? So it's funny, I recently spent a couple of days at the San Diego Zoo, which is I think it's the best zoo in the world, and they're one of the foremost leaders in terms of protecting endangered species and repopulating species that are in danger and rescuing animals and research for better care for animals and all. It's a nonprofit, really doing amazing work. But you go over there, you'd be doing tours and you could see animals mating, right? This is just a natural thing. If you've ever been hiking or camping or anywhere in the wild, you know, this is part of the equation. Animals have sex. Human beings are animals, we have sex too. Now obviously we are cognitive thinkers, we can become critical thinkers, and we can be mindful about the time and the places and the ways in which we perform or practice sex. And that's what I want to talk about, channeling that with sexual transmutation. The other, though, core foundational belief we've got to look at is how you were programmed at an early age. What were your foundational beliefs about people who are gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, anything like that that was different than what most of the people in your family were? Because again, this is a natural thing. This is the way whatever force that created us, it's the way we were created. And this is true in all throughout the animal kingdom. So if you have a belief from one of these religious organizations that gay people or bisexual people or transgender people are flawed, or there's something wrong with them, or they're not gonna get the good rewards or go to the afterlife, you want to question that belief, because that's not a prosperous belief. It's not a belief that serves you. Now, if you say, no, I know this because the Bible said this or the Quran said that, I get there's all of this dogma out there that sometimes ostracizes LGBT people or even incites harmful activity against them. But that's not a prosperous belief, and it's not a belief that has any place in an enlightened society. And if you want to know the science behind it, go to my blog at randygage.com. I have a blog, it's called Prosperity and Sexuality, or Sexuality and Prosperity. And talks about the different, the X and the Y chromosomes, and the different degrees to which people are born with one or the other, and how these gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, all of that, it's actually biological. It's scientific, the evidence is irrefutable. It is a natural state. So if you don't have that belief, you want to question that, because again, it's not a belief that serves you if you are judging those people or think they deserve less, or if you are one of those people and you've bought into the belief that there's something wrong with you, that God made a mistake with you, or you turned away with God because this is a choice you made. That's just nonsense. There's irrefutable scientific evidence to show that is your natural state, or anyone who is, that is their natural state. So let's be very clear on this. Any religious or societal belief that people should be ostracized, harmed, or killed because of their sex or sexuality has no place in an enlightened society and will never take you to a prosperous place. So we have to start with the foundational premise that all people are perfect just the way they are, and it's not our place to judge them, ostracize them, harm them, or kill them, which is what's being taught in some of these organized religions today. For people who are different, or even just women are in some religions, there are some really harmful treatment and opinions about women. That's not prosperous. So let's go to Think and Grow Rich, the fascinating book from Napoleon Hill, one of the seminal works of self-development of the last 200 years, one of the finest. In the book, he talks about how most men don't become really successful until they reach their 50s. And the reason he attributes that to is their ability after 50, when they are finally able to kind of channel their sexual energy and transmutate it into energy. So what does that process look like? Again, let's go back to the animal kingdom. The violent, passionate, forceful way that they mate. If you've ever seen horses being bred, I mean, it is like sharks, by the way, same thing. Sharks actually bite onto their mate, and they're literally holding them with their teeth. I mean, think of the energy that is taken in these things. It shows you the power of sexual energy. And imagine now if you just dissipate that, you're other pursuits, then of course you're diminishing your life force, what the Asians would call the chi, the actual life force you have. So when you're young and you're acting out and you're just so sexually active indiscriminately, you are actually dissipating your life force, particularly men. And why this is more of an issue with men is because men ejaculate. And when they ejaculate, that is your part of your life force that is leaving your body. So, How do you transmutate that? You channel it. I got to say, I really turned my life around at 35. That's when things really worked for me. And the reason why, I had read Think and Grow Rich about 10 times by then. And so by the time I was 35 years old, I was able to channel my sexual energy into positive pursuits, into being mindful about it. So that's your homework for this week, is look at that whole issue with you. What are your core foundational beliefs about sex and sexuality? And then how mindful are you of preserving your life force, of channeling that energy? If you read my, Risky is the New Safe book. You know, I talked in there about how successful people channel a healthy ego. And I think it's the same process when you channel your sexual energy. And one of the things you might want to do is your additional homework is study tantra sex. Because with tantra sex, there are a lot of ways where you can actually, even for men, where you can have orgasms without ejaculations. So you can actually have this amazing, mind-blowing, bed-breaking sex and still not ejaculate, and you're still preserving your sexual energy inside. And when you preserve that, you're able to channel that into productive pursuits. So think about that. And even if you don't want to get into the whole tantra practice, just think about being mindful of how you channel that sexual energy, because you can harness it and unleash it into other positive pursuits to create success and prosperity in your life. What do you think? If you're watching this on Facebook or YouTube, please share your comments. Share it with your feed on Facebook. Give me your thoughts, or like it and share it on YouTube. And if you're listening to this on iTunes, of course, welcome. We're going to do this every week and put it up live on the podcast, so you guys want to listen to it audio when you're working out or jogging or whatever. So have an amazing week. Until next time, peace. Love you guys, and live rich. Hey, make sure you come back next Monday, because we're going to have an all new show, and this is going to be a good one, because we're going to talk about the biggest prosperity lies. See you next Monday.